Hello, everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, July 11th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive right into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Now, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the past 13 months of releases so we can get an idea of how this one stacks up to previous releases. And with that, it's quite a large month when it comes to the number of vulnerabilities. We've been averaging almost 83 vulnerabilities per release. This month, we have 130 new CVEs that are in today's releases. When we look at the number of remote code execution vulnerabilities, these are the ones that typically present the most risk. They would allow a threat actor to install software and other devious deeds. We've been averaging almost 27 and a half per release. This month, there's 37 remote code execution vulnerabilities. Next, I'll talk about scoring. Microsoft uses the industry standard Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 1 and 10, where 10 is the most severe. This month, we have a few vulnerabilities that come in at 9.8 on a scale of 10. We'll talk about those in a few minutes. We've been averaging right around 9.5 for that high point over the last 13 months. The average score across all 130 CVEs comes out at around 7.32. And we've been averaging about 7.28, which is right in line with average there. Next, I'll talk about publicly disclosed vulnerabilities. This month we have one. We've been averaging just under one. Next, I'll talk about vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited out in the wild. We've been averaging right under two of these per month. This month, there are five CVEs that were known to be exploited at the time of release. All right, now let's take a look at this month's release by itself. And those of you familiar with this video, you'll recognize this slide where we put the Windows products that are serviced every single month at the towards the bottom of the slide, and then products that are not serviced as much or every single month are towards the top of the chart. This month is no different. As we can see, Windows has quite a few vulnerabilities being addressed this month. We've been averaging between mid-30s and mid-40s, depending on the specific SKU. And this month, as we could see, it's much higher than that. And the higher number of Windows CVEs is right in line with the total number of vulnerabilities being so much higher than it has been over the past 13 months. As we move up the chart, we see Microsoft Office with 15 vulnerabilities this month. We have Visual Studio, Dynamics 365 with a couple vulnerabilities, Windows Admin Center, .NET 6.0, .NET 7.0, and Microsoft Malware Protection Engine to round it all out. All right, so let's dive into some of the vulnerabilities from today's release, and we'll start with CVE 2023-35365. This is a remote code execution vulnerability in the Windows Routing and Remote Access Service component. This has a base score on a scale of 10 of 9.8. So, extremely elevated here. The attack vector is over the network, the attack complexity is low, privileges required is none, and user interaction here is also none. This was not publicly disclosed, nor was it known to be exploited out in the wild. And there is a mitigation here, specifically that it's only exploitable on Windows servers that have installed and configured the RRAS role, Routing and Remote Access Service, which is not installed or configured by default. And so if you don't have the RRAS role installed, then you're not vulnerable to this. If you do have RRAS installed, then please go ahead and install the cumulative update to protect yourself from this vulnerability. As far as affected components, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support from server 2012 up through the latest server 2022. And then on the desktop side, Windows 10 up to the latest versions of Windows 11. Next, I'll talk about another remote code execution vulnerability in Windows. This one is in the message queuing service. This is CVE-2023-32057. This one, again, hits 9.8 on that CVSS scale that goes up to 10, so elevated when it comes to risk. The attack vector is over the network, the attack complexity is low, no privileges are required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this. This one also has a mitigation in that the message queuing system is not enabled by default. And so if you are not using message queuing service, then you are not vulnerable. You need to first, in order to be vulnerable, a system would have to have the Windows message queuing service enabled and running. And this is a feature that can be added in the control panel. And you can see if this service is running by looking for a service called message queuing on your system in the services section of Windows. As far as affected components, this is, again, is affects all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support from server 2012 through the latest server 2022, as well as the desktop side, Windows 10 up through Windows 11. Next, I'll talk about a vulnerability in Office. This is CVE-2023-33150. This is a security feature bypass vulnerability in Office. This is an important severity, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.6 on that scale of 10, so it's still quite elevated. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, but user interaction here is required. There are no document mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And as far as what a user would have to do, is this is kind of that social engineering thing where a threat actor would have to convince a user to either open a file in email or send a link over IM or some other way that convinces a user to open this document. One key note here is that the preview pane is an attack vector for this vulnerability. Most of the vulnerabilities in Office, they're protected in that preview pane. This one, unfortunately, is not. So, as far as Application Guard for Office, this is not affected. So if you're using Application Guard for Office, you're not vulnerable here. As far as affected software, it's Word 2013, Word 2016, Office Long-Term Servicing Channel 2021, Office 2019, and 365 Apps Enterprise. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And finally, the fourth CVE that I'll be covering in the mini briefing video here is CVE-2023-36884. This is a remote code execution vulnerability in the Office and Windows HTML components. This has a base score of 8.3 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is high. No privileges are required, but user interaction is required. I'll also point out that this was publicly disclosed prior to release, and exploitation has been detected. A few things going on here beyond that is that in this case, Microsoft has published a CVE with no fix. This happens occasionally when Microsoft, in partner with our Finder community, has discovered an issue that needs to be customers be made aware. And typically, even if there's not a fix, what we'll do is release some mitigations. In this case, there's a few mitigations, and I'll point you to the CVE article in the security update guide for the full list. A handful of them may not apply to you. They require some E5 licensing. But one that does apply, if any of the E5 licensing stuff does not, is to set a registry key. Again, the CVE article has more details about the specific key that's in this hive that's listed in the mitigation section, as well as the value for that registry key. As far as affected software, it's both versions of Word and Windows combined. So if you don't have Word installed on your device, you're not vulnerable here, but it's a combination of Word 2013, 2016, Office 2019, Office Long-Term Servicing Channel 2021, excuse me, as well as any of the versions of Windows that are in full mainstream support, whether it's Server 2012 up through the latest 2022, or on the Windows Desktop 10 and 11. For more information, there is a blog that's associated with this vulnerability. It's linked here. It's also linked in the CVE article if you want to read more about this. All right, that brings us to a close. I want to thank everyone for tuning in with me this month, and I will talk to you all in August. Thank you very much.